Right, students, let us start IBPS PO from question number 31. We have data analysis. Here, information is in two images. So obviously, it takes time. What is this? Regarding population, total population is 3000. Out of that, we have four villages A, B, C, D, and these percentages are supposed to calculate on 3000. So first, we have to note it down, and then number of male information is there. To get female information, from the total, we have to subtract respect to male from that particular village. So finally, we are going to frame a table here. It is going to take time. So let's hold this question and write it in index. Because we are not going to complete this, we are going to write index. Data analysis, I am writing one circle and table. That is for just understanding purpose. From 36 onwards, what is that? We have arithmetic questions. So arithmetic questions also we are not going to solve in the beginning. 41 onwards also we have this, 45. From 46 we have wrong number series. Do remember, wrong number series must be given last priority. Be careful, because these are wrong number series, I will hold these questions. Till 50 it should have, yes. From 51 onwards, we have, what are these questions? Data sufficiency. As these are data sufficiency questions, won't take much time. Let's finish it off. Now, what is this? What is the value of P? Is the value of P equal to the value of Q? Is P and Q are equal or not? That's what our question. Sum of P and Q is equal to 16. With this information, we cannot answer the question. The product of sum of P and Q and the sum of reciprocals of P and Q is 4. What exactly is this information? Product of what? Sum of P and Q, that is P plus Q, and sum of reciprocals of P and Q. Sum of reciprocals of P and Q, in the sense 1 by P plus 1 by Q, that is going to be P plus Q divided by PQ is equal to, they said, 4. Now from this numerator, we have P plus Q whole square is equal to 4PQ. PQ goes to the other side. If 4PQ comes to left hand side, P square plus Q square plus 2PQ minus 4PQ, that becomes minus 2PQ. That is P minus Q whole square is equal to 0. And it happens only when P is equal to Q. So we can answer the question saying P is equal to Q by using only second statement information. So 2 alone is sufficient to answer the question. Next, what is the value of A square minus B square? A square minus B square is equal to how much? That's what we have to calculate. Sum of A and B is equal to 16. Using this information, answer cannot be done. Because A square minus B square, in the sense, that can be written as A plus B into A minus B. You know only A plus B value, but you don't know how much is A minus B. Hence, one alone is not sufficient. There is no difference between the values of A and B. If there is no difference between values of A comma B, then A square and B square also, there won't be any difference. So A square value and B square value both will be equal. Hence answer is equal to 0, and we can identify the answer saying 0 is the answer. Next, 0 in the sense we are able to answer the question using information given in only 2. Only 2 is sufficient to answer the question. The cost price of article A is what percentage more than cost price of article B? So you can identify answer if you can relate what is cost price of A and how much is cost price of B. Article A was sold at 20% profit and B was sold at 60% profit. But still, where is the comparison between cost price of A or cost price of B or selling price of A and selling price of B? You know that for A and B, there is a profit of 20% here. So we are selling it at 120% of A. And here we are selling it at 60% profit, that is equal to 160% of B. These are selling prices. But there must be some relation between these two, right? As that is missing here, one alone is not sufficient. Next, the average selling price of article A and that of article B is 10% more than cost price of article A. So cost price of article A should be always 100% of A and B is equal to 100% of B. Now, average selling price of article A and that of article B is 10% more than cost price. But how much is selling price of A and how much is selling price of B? That is missing. Two alone is not sufficient to answer the question. Can you answer question both by using both? Yes, because you know selling price is here. Average selling price in the sense sum of these two divided by two, which is going to be 60% of A plus 80% of B, and that is equal to 10% more than cost price of article A. Cost price of article A is 100%, 10% more in the sense 110% of A. If this value goes to the other side, then 80% of B is equal to 50% of A. Using this, we can identify relation between A by B. A by B is equal to 8 by 5. Using this, cost price of A is 8 parts. Cost price of B is 5 parts. When you know cost prices, definitely you can identify A is what percent more than B. So, answer is both statements are required to answer the question. Next, how much time will car N take to travel 405 kilometers? You need to calculate the time for car N. Car N can travel 480 kilometers in certain number of hours. You don't know how much time it takes, but car M takes 4 hours more than car N to cover the same distance. So 4 hours is the time difference that car M takes and car N takes to cover 480 kilometers. Had car M traveled the same distance with double the speed, it would have taken 2 hours less than car N. So here, initially car M takes 4 hours more than car N. But with the double the speed, it can reach the destination in 2 hours less. Meaning, let us assume car M speed. In first case to second case, the speed ratio is 1 is to 2. Then time ratio should be equal to 2 is to 1. So time reduces by one part here. So this one part is equal to, this one part is equal to. In first case, time taken is 4 hours more. That I can write it as original time T, which is taken by N plus 4. And here, or else directly you can treat it as time taken by N is N plus 4 it is taking. And next case it is taking 2 hours less, that is N minus 2. So time difference is equal to 6 hours only. If one part is equal to 6, if one part is equal to 6, N minus 2 is equal to 6, then N is equal to 8. Now, this is the time taken by car N to cover how many kilometers? 480 kilometers. So if it takes 8 hours to cover 480 kilometers for 405 kilometers, for 405 kilometers, how much time it takes? Can we calculate using this information or not? Definitely we can answer the question. So one alone is sufficient to answer the question. The speed of car M is 40 kilometers per hour. That we can generate it actually. Let's see that. With the original speed, car M can cover the distance in 2 p hours. One part is equal to 6. Then two parts is equal to 12. To cover 480 kilometers, if car M is taking 12 hours, speed of the car is equal to 40 kilometers per hour. Using first statement, we can answer this question. We can get this value. So this is of no use. Only one alone is sufficient to answer the question. Next. The side of the square is equal to the length of the rectangle. Side is equal to length of the rectangle. What is the area of the square? Square area. So either you can calculate L value or the side. Difference between area of the rectangle and the area of the square is equal to 84. Now, A square. Now, do remember, when you have a square and rectangle and there's a difference, it has to be always largest number minus smallest number. For a rectangle, length should be definitely more than the breadth. Now, A square is the square area which is equal to definitely the more than the area of the rectangle because side is equal to length. Let us assume like this. This is rectangle, this is L, and this is breadth. Breadth should be less than length, right? Now we have a square whose side is equal to length of the rectangle. Then डेफिनेटली ब्रेथ इज लेस देन द साइड ऑफ द स्क्वायर, देन ये स्क्वायर शुड बी डेफिनेटली मोर देन एल इन टू बी. नाउ वेन यू टेक द डिफरेंस इट हैज टू बी ए स्क्वायर माइनस ए इन टू बी. इन प्लेस ऑफ लेंथ यू कैन राइट इट एज ए, और एल्स इन प्लेस ऑफ ए ऑल्सो यू कैन राइट इट एज लेंथ. ए स्क्वायर इन प्लेस ऑफ ए स्क्वायर यू कैन राइट इट एज एल स्क्वायर. एल स्क्वायर माइनस एल इन टू बी इज गिवन हियर. How much is that given in question information? 84. So you can take length common. L into L minus B is equal to 84. N number of possibilities may be there. So one alone information is not sufficient to answer the question. The difference between the perimeter of the square and the rectangle is 8. Perimeter of rectangle, perimeter of the square, that is 4A, or you can write it as 4L. And 2L minus 2B, which is equal to 8. 4L minus 2L, that is equal to 2L. 2L minus 2B, in the sense 2 times of L minus B is equal to 8. 2, 4 times here. So L minus B is equal to 4. This can be concluded using only second information. But if L minus B is equal to 4, can we identify how much is L value or how much is breadth value? No. So 1 alone is not sufficient. And 2 alone is not sufficient. Can we get answer using both? Yes. If you can substitute L minus B is equal to 4 in this, L into 4 is equal to 84. From that, L is equal to 21. Then side is equal to 21. When you know the side of the square, you can definitely answer area of the square. A square, 21 square, 441 would be your answer. So both statements are sufficient to answer the question. Both are required to answer the question. Now here, look at this. So far only 5 questions have answered. Students, science, mathematics and English. Total number of marks is equal to sum of marks scored in 3 subjects. 3 subjects here. Maximum marks for each subject is 150. Yes, because the maximum marks for each subject is 150. Though the information is provided in percentage, it is simple to answer the question. Now let's, because this is a single table, and whereas when you concentrate this here we have 2 images, so better to solve this question. Now marks scored by C in science is what percent of the total marks scored by D. Marks scored by C in science, C scored 30%, 30% of 150. That is, what percentage of total marks scored by D? D scored 60% of 150, 40% of 150, 20% of 150. Both numerator and denominator, every value is calculated only on the same number. So you don't have to go for conversion. And you don't have to give importance for that number also. 60, 40, 100, 120, 120. Both these percentages are calculated on 150. Even if you write it, that gets cancelled. So don't write it into 100. 31's year, 34 times year. 1 by 4 in the sense that is equal to 25%. Fourth option, final answer. What is the difference between marks scored by A in mathematics and marks scored by C in English? Difference between marks scored by A in mathematics and that scored by C in English. Right. Now, A in mathematics, 75%. You don't have to write it. And C in English, 50%. Your question is to identify difference. 75% of 150, 50% of 150. Difference is going to be 25% of 150, which is equal to half and half of the number. Half of this number is 75. Again, half is 37 and half. Second option answer. Next. 58. What is the average score, marks scored in English by all 4 students? In English, every person wrote English exam for 150 marks only. When you're asked to calculate percentage, directly you can add all these values, but you're asked to calculate average marks. So don't go for conversion, because every percentage is calculated on only 150. You can directly convert finally. 50, 50, 100. 100 plus 30, 20, that is 150. 150 percentage of this number. 100 percentage is 150. 50 percentage is 75. That is equal to 225. Average is equal to divided by 4. 4, 5 times here, 20. 4, 6 times 24. 1 by 4 can be treated as 25. 56.25, fourth option answer. What is the total marks scored by A, B together? Total marks scored by A and B together. That's what your question. Now, to answer this question, A and B. 65, 75, 140, 140, 30, 170, 170, 200, 240, 290, 290 percentage, 290 percentage of 150, or 150 percent of 290. Getting 150 percentage easy to calculate. 100 percent plus half of that, half of that is equal to 145, and you just asked to calculate how much is the total number of marks scored, which is equal to 435. 435 is fifth option final answer. Next, what is the respective ratio of the total marks scored by A to that scored by C? Total marks scored by A, just now we calculated, that was 170 percentage of 150. And even for C also, total 30 30 60 60 50 110 110 percentage is also calculated on 150, so don't have to write it. 00 gets cancelled. 17 by 11, fourth option answer. Next, 61. These are approximations, so we have to complete it. Under root of 224.99 can be treated as 225, that is equal to 15, plus 13 square 169, minus, this is approximately 144, that is 12 into 4, that is 48. And take 62.99, approximate 63 to the left hand side, that becomes minus 63. Now, 60, 40, 100, 108, 111. Subtract 111 from this number, here you'll have 58. And also we have 15. 15 plus 58, that is equal to 73. 73 is fourth option. Next, 56 divided by 10. And then 12 by 84, directly you can write it as 1 by 7. And then 6 by 5. 7, 8 times here. 6 into 8, 48. 48 by 50. 48 by 50 can be even treated as 48 by 50. Yes, approximate, right? 48 by 50. Approximate answer is 1 only, right? You don't have any answer in decimal. It is an integer. 48 by 50 can be treated as approximate to 1 fifth option answer. Next. 3 square 9 plus 23 plus 288 minus 152 times, that is equal to 300. 9 plus 23, that is equal to 32. To this, if you add 32, it becomes 320 minus 300. Answer is 20, first option. Next, 49 to the power of 1 by 2. 49 can be written as 7 square to the power of 1 by 2, that is equal to 7 into 3 square 9 plus x is equal to 10 into 11, that is equal to 110. 7 9 is 63. If 63 goes to the other side, 110 minus 63, that is equal to 110 minus 63, which is equal to 47. 47 is third option. Next, 8 to the power of 1 by 3. 8 can be written as 2 cubed to the power of 1 by 3, that is 2 into 3 square to the power of 1 by 2, that is 3. 3 into 2, so entire left hand side value is equal to 6, is equal to x square plus 7 square, which is 49, minus, that is equal to 47. 49 minus 47, that is equal to 2. If 2 goes to the left hand side, 2 goes to left hand side, x square is equal to 4 and x is equal to 2. Next, so we have completed all last questions and we are left with only this. Right now, out of data analysis and arithmetic. Let's see first arithmetic questions. Out of these 10 questions, definitely any aspirant can answer 5 to 6 questions easily. Pick those questions. That is very important. Now, at present, Chen is twice the age of Ben and also 7 times the age of Amy. If after 4 years, Ben will be 25 years older, and after 4 years, Ben will be 25 years. Then present age of Ben is going to be 25 minus 4, that is equal to 21. And Amy will be 10 years old. After 4 years, if Amy will be 10, then present age of Amy should be equal to 6. What is Amy's present age? We got the answer, right? So you don't have to even consider what is the first information using here. If after 4 years, Ben will be 25, present age of Ben is 21. And Amy will be 10 years old. At what time? After 4 years. Then present age of Amy is 6. First option answer. Next. On giving a certain discount on MRP of an item, always discount is calculated on only market price. Sean gains 25%. And on giving double the discount, he loses 6.25. So when you subtract X rupees, if provided X is discount, there is a profit, and that profit is 25%. And if you subtract double the discount, if you give double the discount, there is a loss of 6.25. What is difference between both? That is equal to X. Difference between both, that is 31.25. So earlier that number was 31.25 more than 25. So that is 25 plus 31, which is equal to 56. 56.25. So when you are getting 56.25% profit, then market price is equal to 156.25% of the cost price. Then only after giving certain discounts, there will be 25% profit. Next. The cost price of the item is 256. How much discount should he allow on the market price of the item to earn a profit of 24 rupees? Now, 156.25%, that we have to calculate. This can be treated as 100% and 50%. 100% is 256 and 50% is equal to 128. 6 1 by 4% in the sense, that is equal to 1 by 16th. 1/16th of this number is equal to 16. Now this is going to be total market price. 300 380 plus 20, 400. So market price is equal to 400, and your selling price has to be, you are expecting a profit of 24 out of 256 cost price. When you are expecting 24 rupees profit, then selling price is equal to 280. So how much reduction should be there? 120. 120 is what percent of 400? 30%. So if you are asked to calculate how much discount percentage you have to give, answer is 30%. But your question is how much reduction should be there? 120 direct answer, first option. Next. ABC started a business with investments in the ratio 7-6-8 respectively, and the period for which they invested was in the respective ratio 6-4-1. The annual profit received was 18,500. What was the difference between A's share and total share of B and C? So A's share separately we have to calculate, BC shares together we have to separately calculate, and then we have to identify difference between both the numbers. Be careful here. Now A invested seven parts, B six parts, and C eight parts, and the time periods are in the ratio 6 is 2 4 is 2 1. Now cancellation with the 2, 3 times, 2 times, and then 4 times. Now 7 into 3 21, 6 into 2, 12, 4 into 1, 4. So total how many parts we have? 37 parts. Total profit is equal to 18,500. Now 18,500 is divided into 37 parts. Then each part is equal to this much. You know that A is getting 21 parts. BC together gets 16 parts. And the difference is 5 parts. We have to calculate 5 parts, that is into 5. Now 37 exactly 5 times and then 2 zeros. 500 into 5, 2500, fourth option answer. Next. एवरी डे आई एम टेलिंग यू डोंट लीव क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन एजेस एंड प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन पार्टनरशिप. नेक्स्ट, द डिफरेंस बिटवीन टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ फेंसिंग एट द रेट ऑफ 5 रुपीज पर मीटर अ सर्कुलर फील्ड एंड द स्क्वायर फील्ड इज 160. इफ द प्राइस डिफरेंस इज 160 रुपीज फॉर अ सर्कुलर फील्ड and the square field for fencing, fencing in the sense that is equal to 2 pi r and here it is 4a. At the rate of 5 rupees per meter, if the cost difference is 160, then area difference is 160 divided by 5, which is equal to 32. So difference between these two is equal to 32. Now, when I say difference, it may be perimeter of the circle minus perimeter of the square, or perimeter of the square minus perimeter of the circle. It may be anything. Always difference in the sense largest minus smallest, right? So vice versa also may be a possible. Just remember, what is the area of the circular field if the radius of the circular field is equal to the side of the square field? Now, for these type of questions, whenever you are asked to calculate area of the circle, circular field area, answer should be pi r square. So pi is 11 multiple, answer should be 11 multiple. First option 11 multiple, second option 11 multiple, third option is also 11 multiple. Multiple options are there, let's calculate. But there is a condition here that says radius is equal to side of the square field. Radius is equal to side. Now you can say 2 pi r in the sense 2 into 22 by 7 into r minus 4a, in the sense you can write it as 4r, is equal to 32. When you take r common, here also you can take 4r common, 2, take 2 common also, here you have 11 by 7 minus 1, that becomes 11 minus 7 by 7 is equal to 32. Now here 4, how many times? 8 times. 11 minus 7, that is also 4. 4 how many times? 2 times. Then radius is equal to 7 into 2, 14. You are asked to calculate circle area, which is pi r square. 22 by 7 into r square, that is 14 into 14. Now, 7, 2 times here. 22 into 2, 88. 88 into 14. 4 into 8, answer should end with 2. How many options are ending with 2? Sorry. 22, 2 times is 44. 44, 14 times. 44, 14 times. 4 into 4, answer should end with 6. How many options are ending with 6? 2 options are there. 1386, 616. Observe the value. 44, 10 times is 440. 44, 20 times is 880. So answer should be more than 440, less than 880, because you have only 14 times. 14 times in the sense more than 10 times, less than 20 times. Hence, answer should be more than 440 and less than 880 and should end with 6. There is only one option, 616, final answer. The speed of the boat upstream is 6 km per hour, less than the speed of the downstream. Upstream speed is m minus s. Downstream speed is m plus s. Difference between m plus s and m minus s is 2s only. If 2s is equal to 6, then conclusion says s is equal to 3 km per hour. If the speed of the boat in still water is 21, meaning m is equal to 21, what is the total time taken by the boat to travel 108 kilometers upstream and the same distance downstream? 108 kilometers should be traveled in upstream, m minus s, that is equal to 18, and the same 108 kilometers should be traveled in downstream, m plus s, that is equal to 24. Now, 18, 6 times directly, 24, 4 times is 96. Apart from 96, we have 12 more. 12 by 24 in the sense, that is equal to half. 6 hours plus 4 and a half hours, that is equal to 10 and a half hours. 10 hours, 30 minutes, fifth option answer. Next. In 2021, an organization had 1800 employees. In 2022, 55 female employees and 45 male employees left the organization. Okay. If in 2022, the number of female employees was 45 more than number of male employees in 2021, understand this condition. In 2022, female are 45 more than male in employees, male employees in 2021. What was the number of female employees in 2022? That's what your question. Now, I'm talking about 2021 and then 2022. Here you are going to have male and then female and then total also. Initially, 1800 people are there. When you have 1800 people here, and out of female 55 and out of male 45 left the organization, total 55 and 45, 100 people left. Then out of 1800, there is going to be only 1700 people in 2022. In 2022, female was 45 more than male in 2021. If male were X year, then female in 2022 is going to be 45 more. That is equal to X plus 45. Now let's see. What is your question? What was the number of female in 2022? You need to identify how many female are here. That's what, right? Now, if you can identify X value, X plus 45 is your right answer. Now let's see. In 2021, total population we have 1800. Out of 1800, X members are male. Then female are difference. That is 1800 minus X. From 21 to 25, 21 to 22, what happened? 55 female left. So out of this, you should eliminate 55. If you decrease 55 from this number, it becomes 1745 minus X. This has to be equal to X plus 45, that is female in 2022. Take X to the other side, 45 to the left hand side. 2X is equal to 1700. Then X is equal to 1700 divided by 2, that is equal to 850. Final answer. 850 is final answer. 850 should be there. Just a minute. Employees was 45 more than male in 2021. Yes, clear. If it is X, it is 1800 minus X. 55 female employees and 55. If you subtract 55 from this number, 1745 minus X, it has to be equal to X plus 45. X goes to the other side, 45 comes to left hand side. 1700 by 2. Yes, 850 should be there. 850 is right answer. Just change this option to 850. Next, 42. A vessel contains a mixture of 160 liters of milk and 20 liters of water. X liters of mixture was taken out and 20 liters of pure milk and 25 liters of pure water was added. If the resultant quantity of the milk was 100 liters more than the water, what was the value of X? Initially, we have 160 liters of milk and 20 liters of water, right? 160 and 20, milk and then water, right? What is the ratio? 8 is to 1. X liters of this mixture is taken out. Okay, fine. And 20 liters of pure milk and 25 liters of pure water is added. Now, even after taking out X liters, milk should be 8 parts and water should be 1 part. And to this 20 liters of milk we added and 25 liters of water is added. If the resultant quantity of milk was 100 liters more than the water, that means 20 plus 8 parts is equal to 1 part plus 25 plus 100. This is 125. Take 1 part to the other side, that is 7 parts is equal to 125 minus 20, that is equal to 105. Now, after taking out X liters, we have a quantity which is equal to 8 parts and then 1 part, that is equal to 9 parts. 9 fifteenths is equal to 135. Initial quantity was 180, but now after taking out X liters, we have 135. Then how much is X value? Difference between both, that is equal to 45. Fifth option is final answer. Next, 43. Different sums of money was invested in respect to ratio of 8 is to 9 for an equal time period. Equal time period. As the investments ratio is 8 is to 9, let us treat it as 800% and then 900% for simplification purpose. Time period is same. Scheme A offers 5% per annum and scheme B offers R% percent per annum. Both schemes offer simple interest. Okay. Respect to ratio between interest earned from scheme A and scheme B was 20 is to 27. what is the value of R. Now let's see here. Investments are in the ratio 80 is to 9. So I don't want to consider 800% or 900%. Let's directly take 80 is to 9. Time period, let it be T years, and here also T years. And here in scheme A, they are offering 5% interest, and in scheme B, they are offering R percent interest. Investment, time period, rate of interest. That is going to be simple interest. And which is the ratio 20 by 27? 9, 3 times here. First of all, TT gets cancelled. 5, 4 times, 4, 2 times. Then R is equal to 3 into 2. 6% is your final answer. 6% second option. Next. Sean saves 1/3 of his salary each month. From the remaining money is 2/3. From the remaining money, 2/3, he pays 60% as EMI towards the payment of loan. And the remaining is 40%. 40% can be treated as 40 by 100 of the remaining 2/3 of X. Out of the remaining money, he spends on buying a watch. If the difference between the amount he spent on watch and EMI, look at this. On EMI, he spent 60%. And to buy watch, remaining is 40%. That's what we have taken. Difference between 60% and 40% is equal to 20%. And that 20% is calculated on 2/3 of the money, which is equal to 5,400. Monthly salary is equal to how much? That's what your question. You can treat it as 1 by 5. 2,2700. Then X is equal to 5 into 3, 15 times of this number, 2700 into 15. How do we calculate 15 times? Take 10 times and half of it. 10 times is equal to 27,000 and half of that is equal to 13,500. Answer is 40,500, fifth option answer, 40,500. Respect to ratio between the number of days taken by 27 men to complete a project and that taken by 15 women to complete the project is 1:2. If 18 women complete the project in, this is 13 1 by 3 days, that is not 13√3. What is the number of days taken by 24 men to complete the project? Your question is to identify 24 men to complete the project. Now let's see here. 18 women can complete the project in 13 1 by 3. So 18 women can do the work in 13 1 by 3 can be written as 40 by 3 days. Now, in your information, they said 15 women can complete the same project in how many days? Let us calculate that. 15 women can do it in how many days? Women cancel. 3, 6 times. 3, 5 times. 3, 2 times. 5, 8 times. 2 into 8, 16. So now 15 women can do it in 16 days. This information says 27 men can complete the work in one day, one part. 15 women can do it in two parts. 15 women can do it in 16 days, which is equal to two parts. From this, one part is equal to 8 days. This says 27 men can complete the work in 8 days. If 27 men can complete the work in 8 days, what is your question? 24 men can complete the work in how many days? 24 men can do it in how many days? Men gets cancelled. 8, 3 times here, 3, 9 times here. 9 days is our final answer, which is second option. Next. So from 46, we have wrong number series. So we are not supposed to touch wrong number series. Now again, let's go to index. This is over. Now we have data analysis and wrong number series. Out of these two, data analysis must be given first priority. Wrong number series you are not supposed to touch. Let's complete wrong number series once after completion of data analysis. Come on. Here we have 12%. Out of 3000, 1% is 30. 12% in the sense that is equal to 360. We have A, B, C and D. Total population. 28% in the sense 28 into 30. 28 3 times. 28 3 times is equal to 840. 34%, 34 3 times, that is equal to 1020. 26 3 times, that is equal to 78. 78. Now this is total population, but here you are given how many male are there. Male population, in A we have 160, B we have 440, 440, 570, 390, 440, 570 and 390. Yes. Now difference between total and male will give you female. Let us do it when it is really required. Now in 2022, this given data is for 2021. In 2022, if the population of village C decreased by 25% as compared to the previous year, previous year it was 1022. If it decreases by 20%, 25%, 1/4, right? 1/4 in the sense, for 2 times, 5 times and then 5 times. If 255 is decreased, instead of this, let's subtract 300 at 45. When you subtract 300, 720 plus 35, 730 plus 45, that is 765. Now, what was the population of village C in 2022? In 2022, it has to be 765. 765 is fourth option. Next. Number of male in village B is what percent more those in village A? Male in village B, 440. What percent more than village A? 440 is how much more than 160? 280, right? 280 more with respect to 160 percentage into 100. 100% of denominator is 160. 150 percentage is equal to 160 plus 80, which is equal to 240. So your numerator is 280. Answer should be, this value is more than 240. Hence, answer is more than 150%. 150 cannot be your answer. 200% of denominator is equal to 320, but your numerator is less than that. So answer should be in between 150 and 200. There is only one option, 175, final answer, done. Otherwise, 0, 0 gets cancelled. 4, 7 times, 4, 4 times, 7 by 4 in the sense, 1, 3 by 4, 1 in the sense, 100%, 3 by 4 in the sense, 75%. That is total 175%, fifth option. Next, out of the population of village B and D, if 540 and 380 respectively are illiterates, what is the respective ratio between literates in village B and D? In village B, we have 840 and 780. 840 and 780. These are total population. 840, 780. Out of this, from village B, 540 are illiterates. And here, 380 are illiterates. 840 minus 540, that is equal to 300. 780 minus 380, that is equal to 400. These are literates. So literates ratio is equal to 3 by 4, that is equal to 3 is to 4, second option answer. What is the average number of female in village A and B? Average number of female in village A and B, 360. Out of total 360, 160 are male, 200 are female. Out of 840 total, 440 are male, then remaining 400 are female. Sum is equal to 600, but your question is about average. 600 by 2, that is equal to 300, fourth option answer. Next, what is the difference between total number of male in village A, C together and number of female in village D? A and C, male, 160 and then 570, that is equal to 730. 730. And female in village D, out of 780, 390 are male, remaining 390 are female. So you're asked to calculate difference between these two. Instead of subtracting 390, subtract 400, add 10. When you subtract 400, it is 330 plus 10, 340. 340 is final answer. That is first option. So now except wrong number series, we have completed everything. Now if you are left with time, solve wrong number series and the close reasoning, close quantitative aptitude session, right? This is the strategy that you are supposed to follow for this particular paper. We'll meet in next class. Thank you.